that is Sanatana. Sanatana is not dharma, actually it is a spirituality stream. And from there, when we degrade ourselves as the time goes, we forget about value, education, a lot of things. The problem is when we get to the darkness, when we are losing our awareness, we go turbulence. That's why Lord Sri Krishna told Yada Yada Itharamse, Dhanu Bhuti Bhakta, Abhu Dhanama Dhanamse, Tadatmanam Sajjana, Paritranaya Sadhana, Guna Sajya Dusruttam, Dharam Santhapna Arthaya Sambhavami Yuge Yuge. That's why, in the form of giving awareness to the society, Swami Dhyana Saraswati Ji incarnated. And from there, the revolution started regarding to make people aware. The problem is, when it was an intellectual society, we were not need to get more explanation. For example, Valmiki, Rishi Valmiki, he enlightened himself just reverse of the word Maram Maratu, Ram Ram, and enlightened himself. He need not to get lot of literature or anything. But as the scenario is coming here, we need everything more elaborative information, more descriptive. So Swami Dhyana Saraswati Ji, he was enlightenment toward the Vedas. He again established Vedas. But still there is a lot of things we need to understand what was the purpose behind all. Because without darsana we cannot perform our spiritual life. Religious practice is not a complete part of our Hinduism. It is spiritual part which will take us in the right direction. We have to be more spiritual. The thing is, it is not just simple Om as we are thinking about. It is something beyond that. And we have to explain and understand it properly. If we are not understanding Om, then we are not understanding our spirituality as well as Hinduism or Arya Samaj. Okay? So what is that? We have to understand. Tasya Vachak Parnava. It is a word taken from the Patanjali Yoga Sutra. And this is total, a complete word which can make you complete. However, I will explain. In Rig Veda, Khilakhand 10.171, Prayanta Pranavamkaram Pranavam Cha Maheswaram Omkaram Pranavadmana Tanmayamana Siv Sankaram Mastu. So it is saying, it is itself Lord Shiva. Okay? Everything Om. Om that is Brahma, Om that is Vayu, Om that is Atmana, Om that is the Supreme Truth, Om that is all, Om that is the multitude of the bodies of creatures. Omati Brahma, Omita, is in a Om. I will tell and you will experience it direct. What we are doing here, just following blindly Om Kar. We are just following blindly. How it is? Om. This is Omkar sound in Omkar. Omkar sound is lengthy. Second is Om. Oh sorry. Om. This is Ukar that is representing Lord Vishnu. He is giving the power to explain, elaborate and spread it. And then to calm down. That is Om. That is Makar is lengthy. Here you will calm down because serum will be vibrate, your neuron system and brain will calm down. If you have stress, you can release. If someone is having high blood pressure, you can control it immediately. If it is shooting up, you just start 51 Om chanting with Makar sound alone, you will calm down. Your blood pressure will calm down. So this is something more elaborate because it is combined of several sciences taken from the yoga. Without understanding the philosophy of yoga, you are not following the yoga. Om is a part of yoga also. How? You will see here. Can you see Omkar here? How it is written? Can you see the Omkar shape here? It is something more known than. We have three cyclic nodes in our body existing in our Muladhara Chakra, which we say pineal plexus. Second is on Anahata Chakra, that is known as cardio plexus. And third is existing at Anjana Chakra, which is here. So these are three psychic nerve glands which we have to open. Okay? What is the ikar? You see, there is ikar instead of ukar. You see? And here there is a tail. You can see? In the alphabet of Hindi, E is having 3.5 lobes. That is a symbol of the Kundalini. That is always working and moving from upward to downward, downward to upward when we are unawakened. When Kundalini is not awakening, till then it is moving to keeping us alive, to digest the food, to create the world and moving as a person, normally moving person. If we will understand after yogic practice, when Kundalini awaken, we move upward side, otherwise it is from downward side and keeping us alive with the pranic activity, what we are inhaling, that give the vibration there, and when it give vibration, it move and keep us alive. If we will know how it is flowing, we have to understand the structure of the womb. It is the same when womb is there. Womb, there is a tail, it will come in the center, and upper side there is a half moon. You can see that this half moon is beyond the Arya Chakra. It is here where you can see when child takes birth, and there is a palpitation into the head. Here we can see tak. It is here. That is Guru Chakra. From here you are not coming back to take birth. You are breaking the life and death cycle. Okay? And then there is a Dhenu upper side. That is Brahmasana. There you complete your journey and you are not taking coming back. So this is the Omkar we have to follow. And how it is? Simon ji, can you please come forward? I want you. Because I have to tell what is Omkar in our body. How many people are here who studied the skeletal system? Yeah? Okay. Well. If we will stand from the side, what is happening in the spine? You will see there are three karvas. From here, downward side. And from here, it is again upward side. The spine is moving just like a upa. Okay? Vishuddhi chakra, medulla oblongata, cardio plexus, and the Muladhara chakra. This is the shape of U. It is happening here. Then, after Arya chakra, there is a half moon. It is in yoga practice when you understand where is our chakras existing and what is the shape. Half moon position of the Arya chakra, Guru chakra is the half moon like this. And there is Sahasrara chakra. It is taking shape here in our body. The formation of Omkar is not apart from our body. Thank you, Sanjay. So we have to understand it and follow this practice. And when we do the practice, we have to focus on these things. That is Omkar. And that was my subject to tell you people. Don't follow your Sanatana as a Hindu. Sanatana is a practice of spirituality instead of the religious practice. And we have to go back for the Vedas. Vedas are coming from the Sanatana instead of religious practice. We have to go back, understand it properly, follow the right way, do not follow it blindly. This is my request, and that was my purpose to give the explanation overall. Every year, yoga is very much important part. Yoga teaches you how you can become the spiritual person. So, we know the yoga, yama, niyama, asana, pranayama, pratyahara, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. All these are making you more spiritual step by step. Follow properly. Thank you very much for the day. Have a great day.